Hello, viewer. Welcome back to Artistry. My name is Dennis Ongweso. Presenting you a topic in electrical engineering under AC circuits under the subtopic we call RC circuits. Before we proceed with this, let us remind ourselves on what we learned last time. Last time we were dealing with RL circuits. We managed to see the connection between the resistance and inductance, and we say that this is the circuit in RC. This is the resistor, this is the inductor, and we say that for you to combine this and this, you have to change this inductance to what we call XL. XL is the inductive reactance, and we said it is given by 2 pi FL. L is the inductance, F is the frequency, and the frequency in the Kenyan system, it is standard 5th hertz, unless otherwise specified. And we say that impedance is given by R squared plus XL squared square root ohms. And again, we said power factor was given by cos theta or R over Z, R or impedance. That's all about what we discussed last time. Now let us go back to our today's topic. Today we are learning on RC circuits, how you can constitute a circuit comprising of resistance and capacitance. Capacitance, we derive this term from the word capacitor. A capacitor is a static. Capacitor is a static device for storing charge. Static device for storing charge. It can be used for various applications, like in our radios at home, we tune that tuning knob. It's comprising of capacitors, which are making it to work properly. And the term capacitance is the ability of the capacitor to store charge. And in an electric circuit, we normally represent a capacitor by these symbols. Or you can represent a capacitor by this, positive, minus, to show the positive plate and the negative plate. Or you can represent a capacitor by this. This means this is a variable resistor. A variable capacitor. It is adjustable. You can adjust this to the value which you may want. Now, a circuit of resistor and a capacitor is now drawn as this. And we discuss it. Now let us see. C is the capacitance. For you to make this and this compatible, you must change this C to what we call inductive capacitance. Inductive capacitance is given by XC and is given by 1 over omega C, which is equivalent to 1 over 2 pi FC. That's how we can get that formula. And also we have the impedance triangle of this. It is normally drawn upside down for some reasons. This is theta, this is R, XC, this is Z. It is drawn this way because the current is in a the current in a capacitor, it lacks the current in the resistor, unlike the other way around for inductance. So using Pythagoras theorem, z squared equals to r squared plus x c squares. That's using Pythagoras theorem. If you can make z square root both sides, it will be this. The unit is ohms. That is the impedance. At the same time, we can have the power factor. Power factor is given by cos theta. And the cos theta is given by, when you use Sokatoa, when you use Sokatoa, so cos theta is given by the adjacent over hypotenuse R over Z. That's how we normally have the expression in that format. So up to that point, we can review our lesson for today. We have said that an RC circuit is a circuit comprising of resistance and capacitance. Just our resistor and the capacitor, simply that. These two elements, when you have these two elements, you can say that you have an RC circuit. We have managed to come up with this expression. We have said that XC is given by 1 over 2 pi FC, and Z is given by R squared plus XC squared, and then square root. Also, we have said that power factor is given by cos theta, which is the same as R over Z. So these are the elements. And capacitance, it can be given by other formulas. For example, if you have a circuit like this, this is a 10 microfarad, this is 10 ohms. Now you are being asked to find the circuit impedance. Circuit impedance and the current in the circuit. Find the circuit impedance and the current in the circuit. Z, this is the impedance, is given by R squared plus XC squared, square root, and XC is given by 1 over 2 pi FC. That implies that XC is 1 over 2 pi FC. That's F is 50 times 10 microfarad, means times 10 minus 6. If you can calculate that, you can have, you can calculate that. We have 2 times pi times 10 raised to power minus 6. And then 1 divided by that, it will be 7.5 ohms. So 7.5 ohms, if now you print this formula, Z is 10 squared plus 7.5 squared. That is 7.5 squared. So we have approximately 14.01 ohms. That is the total impedance of the circuit. If now the voltage is given by 240 volts, therefore current is given by V over Z, so it will be 240 over 14.01. 240 divided by 14.01, so it will be 17.131 amperes. So that's how you can analyze an expression for that circuit. And let's stop at that point. I have been your presenter, Dennis Ongweso. Keep tuned to Elimu TV. Thank you.